I would like to welcome to the stage, to kick this off, the Honorable Mayor Reed.
Good morning. Thank you all for being here today. This is a great opportunity for leaders like yourself to get to Montgomery, Alabama, and learn a little bit about what we've been doing here. But I know most importantly, we're just glad to offer our presence and our thanks for you, for your service and for your leadership, not only to this community and the communities that you reside in, but also to this country and this world. So we appreciate everything that you do. We're glad to have you here in Montgomery, Alabama. This has always been a place of change. This has always been a place that challenged and pushed the envelope, so to speak. And we've always been a place where people believe in strong leadership. Strong Air Force leadership like former retired General Bernard Randolph, who is my wife's uncle, who's a retired four-star general in the Air Force. Leaders like that have always created change all the way through civil rights leaders, such as E.D. Nixon, Ralph Abernathy, Joanne Robinson. Why am I bringing up these leaders? Because these are leaders that you don't probably know, but you would know this last one. That's Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Those were the leaders that helped spur him as a 26-year-old pastor right here in Montgomery, Alabama, to lead civil protests for 382 days. Something that was supposed to be a one-day protest lasted 382 days that changed this entire nation and the world. But the leaders that I mentioned to you are probably people that you never heard of because they weren't out front. So leadership, we know, starts not just with the people who are out front like me, but often with the people who are beside you and sometimes behind the scenes that are pushing for that change. One of the reasons why I ran to be mayor of Montgomery, Alabama, which I have done now for a robust 115 days, is because I want to be the thermostat and not the thermometer. We wanted to set the temperature as opposed to take the temperature. And one of the things that we'll talk about, and I want to hear from you as well as the other speakers, is what does that look like in your mind? What does that leadership look like? Often we confuse management with leadership. I was told a long time ago, management is maintaining the status quo and leadership is changing it. And so as leaders, we expect you all to do that within your own capacity. And what we want to do here in Montgomery, Alabama, is be a partner with you and be a continued partner with the Air Force. But leadership isn't easy. You can't lead with an ear to the ground and a finger to the wind. It's an undignified position. So if you're going to lead, you have to be willing to step out there on faith, and you have to be willing to trust your moral judgment about what it is you're doing. And I believe that's important whether you're in the military or whether you're someone like me that's in an elected office, because not all elected officials are leaders. I would say most of them are not. Most are managers. But those that are leaders actually look to influence and impact change in a positive way. That's what we're doing in Montgomery, Alabama. We look forward to continuing to do that with you, and we're glad to have you here, and we hope you enjoy your stay. Thank you so much.